The BRICS Alliance kickstarted the de-dollarization agenda and is advancing at a rapid pace to bring the US dollar down. From convincing other countries to ditch the US dollar to settle trade in local currency and planning to launch a new payment system similar to SWIFT, all ideas are finally placed on the deck. De-dollarization is now the most loved word among developing countries in the hopes of strengthening their local currencies and native economies. BRICS is convincing them that cutting ties with the US dollar leads to growth and prosperity. However, that is far from reality, as developing countries need the US dollar to thrive and survive. Without the US dollar, their economies could tank and local businesses could collapse, as their native currencies cannot withstand the waves of the market. The US dollar is seasoned for decades overlooking all market turbulence and still takes the top spot. Commodities expert Jeffrey Christian explained that the BRICS idea of de-dollarization is a myth and nonsensical. He told clients in a presentation this year that de-dollarization is a bad joke and must not be taken serious. This is laughable. You don't take challenge that your opponent throws at you as a joke. Rather, you take it as a challenge, you take it with both hands, and you do whatever it takes to come out stronger than ever. But it might be that he said that in order not to demoralize their clients, in order to make their clients to feel more comfortable while they work under the table to win this challenge. So it is only time we talk. And must not be taken seriously. Explain that countries that are eager for de-dollarization are already facing a series of economic consequences. You know, to some extent, they are right that when some of these countries start ditching the US dollar in the beginning, some businesses will collapse. Yes, but some businesses will still come out stronger, and it will still give birth to some new businesses, because it took time before the US dollar gain the spot it has been maintaining for so many years, and it equally take time to sanitize people from this mindset, business owners from this mindset, making them to understand that by trading in their local currencies has a better benefit than using the US dollar. It has what it takes to stabilize their economies. It will take time, but it is worth the gamble, because we all know that as long as most of these countries or the world is using US dollar as their money reserve, whatever affects the dollar affects the economies of these countries. That is just the truth. Therefore, the question of operating the US dollar is far from reality, as they are unable to pull their own economies out of a crisis. The US dollar has been the dominant currency for more than 7 decades, and bringing it down is no easy task. De-dollarization is a term that sounds good on paper, but it is difficult to bring to reality. BRICS is living in a dystopian world if they think the Chinese yuan will replace the US dollar, he said. There are a lot of people who are hesitant to trade and hold reserves and wealth and bank accounts in Chinese yuan because it is a full free moving currency. So there are limits to it, he said, on the BRICS idea of de-dollarization to Business Insider. So, but truth be told, I hope that at the end of the day, yes, that BRICS will win this fight against the US dollar, because at the end of the day, for 70 good years, the US dollar has been a legal tender in the world. And what benefits has it brought to this most of these developing countries? The answer is, when you go and do your homework, the disadvantages are far more than the advantages, because if you check for most of these 70 years, most of these developing countries, their economies has been nothing to write home about. So gambling or taking the challenge of the de-dollarization agenda by most of these developing countries is not a bad one, and if they succeed, it will lead to economic revolution that you can't imagine.